world, it's the big pour in downtown Crossing, a massive concrete job to fill the hole at the site of the old Filene's building. That site has been a blight on the city for years, and now a new chapter is finally about to be written. Our Todd Kaskevich is live in downtown Crossing with the story. Todd?
And Pam, the work here has been going on since about 2 o'clock this morning. They're now on their second shift of workers. This is going to go to a third shift. It's going to go all night. This is significant not just because of the amount of concrete being poured, but the economic revitalization this project promises to usher in to downtown Crossing. The crater once filled by Filene's basement in downtown Crossing is now being filled with concrete. This major pour is one of the first phases of construction on the new Millennium Tower, seen in these renderings from the developer.
Today we are pouring a 6,000-yard slab pour, which is going to hold the whole structure of the building.
The slab being poured will have a thickness ranging from 6.5 feet to 9.5 feet. It's a job that will go all weekend.
It's the biggest pour right now in Boston, I believe, that's ever been done.
The concrete will come up to the top of rebar that's already in place. Much of what is now a hole will eventually be the parking garage for the new building. At 600 feet, 55 stories, Millennium Tower will be Boston's tallest residential skyscraper. The luxury condo building is scheduled to be completed in 2016.
They want this slab monolithic, which means everything poured together in one solid chunk of concrete. Usually we come in and we pour a section and a section. They want this one solid chunk so it can support the whole building.
So does the weather hurt you or does it not matter?
The weather affects a little. We get a little water in the slab, but we push it out with the concrete, so it shouldn't be that big of a factor.
So they worked right through the rain we had earlier today, and right now we have a little bit of a lull. The rain has tapered off. Initially, they were estimating that this job was going to take about 36 hours. The good news is that as of right now, they're actually running ahead of schedule. Live from downtown Crossing, Todd Kaskevich, WCVB, News Center 5.